Welcome, friends, to this afternoon session of our monthly meeting. I will now take up a few questions that you have sent to me, and Jonathan will read them out. I'll try to hear as best as I can. I don't have my hearing aid on, but then I'll read it myself again and try to answer those questions. Thank you.
I'll try and be extra loud. What level of meditative achievement needs to be accomplished by devotee in order for PLM to take devotee back to Sach Khand?
What level of meditative achievement needs to be accomplished by a devotee in order for PLM to take devotee back to Sach Khand? The only effort needed by a devotee is to reach the third eye center. After that, the master takes full responsibility.
How do I stay loving and be highly competitive in sports?
How do I stay loving and be highly competitive in sports? Love the sports also alongside. No problem. If you love your master, you will love everything you do, including sports.
Our physical life is predestined. Are our dreams also predestined?
Our physical life is predestined. Are our dreams also predestined? It depends on what we understand from the word predestined. If everything is predestined at the physical level, we have no free will. We can't seek. So nothing is predestined here. We make our decisions. It's only when we go to a higher level, we find what we thought was our free will was predestined. But then we reach the astral plane and we feel things are happening according to a pattern that we have set up. So our will is being used there also. And when we go to causal plane, we find whatever was happening at the astral plane was completely predestined. When we go to causal plane, we are making our own videos, our own DVDs. We feel we have got free will, we are making everything, nothing is predestined at all. We are making our destiny. When we go to our true home, we find even that was all predestined. So when we say predestined, it's predestined for a higher level. There it is predestined, not here. We cannot feel it predestined here. Here we feel we have to make our destiny. So predestination depends upon which level we are talking of. At every level, the higher level predestines what we have to do here.
How do I stop the negative thought loops that spin in my head?
How do I stop the negative thoughts?
Loops.
How do I can see it better without. That's too funny. Did you like the show? Okay. How do I stop the negative thoughts loops that spin in my head? Think of positive things. You have to beat the negative thoughts that will come automatically into your head by inducing into your head, inducting into your head, introducing into your head positive thoughts. The very fact we chant mantras, we repeat mantras, is to do that same thing, so that the mind is occupied in repeating what you tell it to repeat and not the negative thoughts. the more you can tell the mind what to think, the less negative thoughts you have. So put positive thoughts and simran and mantra into your thoughts, and negative thoughts will be squeezed out.
You talk of the hunts and bunts. Can you please express how the master configures in Sach Khand and beyond? Is Sat Purush different from hunts and bunts?
You talk of the hunts and bunts. Actually, they are not hunts and bunts. They are hunts and bunts. We write them H-A-N-S and B-A-N-S, but here it's H-U-N-T-S and B-U-N-T-S. Correct a little spelling and the pronunciation. Hunts and bunts have been mentioned in some scriptures, that those souls who have come out of the totality, out of Sach Khand, and return to it become hunts. And those who are staying there, not leaving, are called bunts. And the hunts are those who have had experiences, therefore they can appreciate their true home much better than the bunts. Can you please express how the master configures in Sach Khand and beyond? Is Sat Purush different from hunts and bunts? Sat Purush, when we say, is totality of consciousness, is not individual. Hunts and bunts are individual. In Sach Khand, in our true home, there being no space and time, the one and the many exist simultaneously. There's one and the many. There's one glass of water and there are many drops of water. But they're not different. The many drops of water in this glass are the same as one glass of water. So the oneness includes the manyness in our own true home. Therefore, we experience oneness and manyness at the same time. And that is why that totality, all hunts and bunts are together in that manyness. Hunts who have had an experience outside of the glass and those who did not go outside of the glass. The few drops that go out are very few drops compared to those who are still back. The number of hunts is very small compared to the number of bunts. One is small infinity, one is big infinity, if it makes any sense.
After death, does each person have to experience both hell and heaven for periods of time before being reincarnated? Can one only be at hell or heaven? Are there any hells in the causal region? What does it mean when one sees dead relatives and friends in a dream?
Can you read okay?
After death, does each person have to experience both hell and heaven for periods of time before being reincarnated? Can one only be at hell or human or heaven? Are there any hells in the causal region? What does it mean when one sees dead relatives, friends in a dream? First part, not everybody has to go through hell or heaven. It depends on the karma. Most of us do not have such good karma to go to heaven. So most of us don't go there. Most of us don't have such bad karma as to go to hell. So majority of us don't go to hell. It's only a small number who have exceptionally good life, dedicated to purity, spirituality, service of people, doing great good deeds, as the person understood good deeds, that go to hell, heaven. Heaven is a place of pleasure and joy. We feel very happy there because everything is arranged for us beforehand. And it's a great visit. If you like to visit the heaven, you can at the astral plane. Heavens and hells are all in the astral plane. People who worship God in religion are referring to a God who is the Lord of that heaven in the astral plane. So that is why they always talk of going to heaven, and the Lord is there, and he is a being. He's not a totality of consciousness. He's an actual being, an actual soul who has ascended to the region of a god because of his good karma here. So that is why heaven is a very great place to go to for good karma. The best karma only takes you to heaven. And the period you spend there is also dependent on how good your karma was, for how long it was. Hell is similarly a terrible place with a lot of torture and pain is inflicted also in the causal plane, also the astral plane. And only those with very bad karma go there. How much time they spend, again, depends on how they have indulged in cruelty and bad deeds, what they consider bad in this physical life. So that is why you don't always have to go there. And very few people go. Not everybody goes to heaven or hell. Though we all wish we could all go to heaven, but we reincarnate back into different forms of life. Those are also just forms of life. There are no hells or heavens in the causal plane. The causal plane is the creative plane for all hells and heavens and other experiences below. All sensory experiences are generated and placed in the astral and physical plane alone. When one sees dead relatives or friends, it is only showing that you are still attached to them. Our attachment brings up the images and sometimes brings up memories, sometimes brings up new images. But very often, when we are seeing those dead relatives have no idea about it. They are being brought up by our own attachment, our own memory of the relationship with our dead relatives. But if the dead relatives are themselves attached to us, then they are not in the astral region, they are in the overlap of the astral and physical region, and they could be roaming around in your own house where you are. They could be as close as sitting next to you, trying to talk to you, but you can't hear them. And in that case, those disembodied dead forces, they are not souls, they are astral selves. They are trying to be in touch with you, so you feel their presence. And if you are also attached to them, they come more often to you and they spend more time with you.
You often say that the only thing, the only common thing in all religions is that they are the best and others are not. However, there are many other common things, like bowing down in prayer, fasting, etc. Could you please clarify your remarks?
You often say that the only common thing in all religions is that they are the best and others are not. I didn't say best. I said they are the only one that will save you. They are the only ones that give you true spiritual path. All others are fake and they'll take you somewhere wrong. Only those will take you to heaven, others will take you to hell. This was what I discovered after studying 11 religions at Harvard University. It was a big surprise for me. I thought the common factor would be love for everybody, things like that. No, many of these religions even taught cruelty as part of religious rituals and practice. So it was a very strange study for me. But the only common thing is they are the only real ones as a spiritual path. All others are fake. One more.
What is the meaning of life?
What is the meaning of life? The meaning of life is you can go to McDonald's and have a good burger. Meaning of life is that you are here to have an experience which you cannot have anywhere else. Your meaning of life is that you are here to experience something that could not be experienced even in your true home. The experience of duality, the experience of pairs of opposites, the experience of adventure, the experience of something known and unknown. These are experiences only available in a life, in the physical body, in the physical plane. But if you want to know what's the purpose of life, which is not the meaning of life, the purpose of human life is gives you an opportunity to escape from a level of experiences which are only confining you to physical level, dream level, reincarnation, to physical level, dream level, and physical level in 8.4 forms of life, which includes plants, insects, birds, animals, and angels in the heavenly spheres, in the overlap. All these experiences are possible, and that's the purpose of life, is to be able to get out of it while we are human. If you are not human, we miss the chance till the next time comes up. Thank you very much for listening to me attentively, and I hope that what we share here is useful to you. It's not really meant for just listening, it's meant for picking up some point which you think will help you further in your own journey. And meditation is a good way to validate what I'm saying. Meditation will not take you to a true home. Meditation is done with the mind, with effort, always. So what is done with the mind cannot take you beyond the mind. So that is why meditation builds up faith, because our mind likes to believe what it can see. Very often, the mind even disbelieves what it can see if it doesn't like what it sees. For example, you can have inner experiences and feel wonderful and say, Master, show me the reality. This is not real. And then your son dies in an accident. And you say, how could that happen? How could this tragedy take place when I have full faith in a master? And a whole idea, concept of everything being judged from physical events comes back. And even the experiences you have had up to the causal plane do not hold your faith together. So that is why meditation, to go to higher levels, and if you have gone beyond the mind, you will never be upset with whatever happens in this life. So that is why I recommend that try to go, even have a little time for experiences beyond the mind. Discover who you are. Discover what the soul is. Discover what life is. Without soul, there is no life anywhere. So life itself is being created from the soul. So go and discover what's creating life in you, rather than say, what's making me understand things, what's making me see things, what's being... All these are dependent upon life. No life, you can't have a mind, you can't have a body, you can't have senses, you can't have anything. So life is yourself. So go beyond the mind and see what life is, and then there will be no problem left for you ever. You'll see the whole thing created the way it was supposed to be created. It's a very big change. And yet, this can all happen while you're still living in a human body in this place. What a great adventure. What possibility is possible in a human being? It's not possible in any other form of life. As a human being, you can experience your soul. You can experience even your true home while you're still alive in the physical body. And continue to function for the remaining part of your life here with full awareness. If you go to totality of consciousness in this life, these perfect living masters are there. The experience is completely different. The experience is you are at all levels at all times. You are in physical plane, astral plane, causal plane, spiritual plane, totality, all at the same time, because everything that you are experiencing at all levels is part of totality. It's not outside. We are not left our home to come here. We have left the awareness of our home and come here. Big difference. There's not a home somewhere else. Our home is where we are right now. Satchkhand is right where we are. We have lost the awareness of it. And the meditation and the love of a master pulls you back in total awareness, and the totality of awareness is the totality of consciousness from where we originated. And this is possible in human life. What a great thing it is. This is the best thing that can ever happen. I cannot think of anything that can happen to a human being better than this, to be able to have that awareness which will sit with you for 24/7. It doesn't go away. You can sleep, you can be awake. That awareness never leaves you. So that is why perfect living masters, when they come here, They look like ordinary human beings, just like us. No difference. They walk like us, talk like us, do things like us, fall sick like us, die like us in the physical bodies. And yet, when you interact with them, they are talking from all levels at the same time. And not only talking to us who are here, they are talking to many souls at other levels at the same time. They do their work at many levels. When a perfect living master initiates us, and you die, and you go to the astral plane, he's still there and taking care of you. There are souls that have been there for thousands of years, and their perfect living masters are with them even now. Perfect living masters are physically died. Disciples are physically died, and yet they are together. And if you go to that plane and stay long enough, you can see them. Same thing at causal plane. Perfect living masters, ordinary human beings walking around on this planet, are working at all levels at the same time. They are themselves totality. Great master was once asked, explain the spiritual path in simple terms, which we can all understand. He said, spiritual path starts with a perfect living master, continues with a perfect living master, ends with a perfect living master. That's the spiritual path. The spiritual path is the human being you are seeing is the path. But you can't believe it. How can he be path when we are just like him? Human beings, human mind does not accept it. Therefore, they become what we used to call disguised people. And they work in disguise like ordinary human beings. And gradually they reveal themselves to you. Ultimately they find they were the destination. They are your true self, sitting as a separate human being here. So it's a remarkable spiritual journey. I have tried so many spiritual journeys which people are teaching and inducting and initiating people into. I got initiated to so many of them myself. They are nothing compared to the possibility that a perfect living master gives us. And he does not say you have to go all the way up. He says, come to the railroad station, come to the airport. I am holding the tickets for you and myself. We'll travel together. This journey is together with a companion, a friend, and you can find no better friend than that. So I am very happy to share these things because you're very lucky that you can have the same experience I have had. And the great master said, I could have had the same experience he had. So that is why they say a philosopher's stone can turn iron into gold. But this philosopher's stone, a PLM, perfect living master, turns iron into philosopher's stone, makes it exactly like himself. It's a wonderful thing. Thank you very much. I'll see you next month again.